A helmed horror. Oh boy. Yep, here it comes.
Hey, how are things going?
Oh, don't let it get her. I think we fought these helmed horrors in a random house in Baldur's Gate. That and a bunch of others, Doom Guards, I think, as well.
Go pester someone else.
Go for the ice.
Give us
Go
victory.
For the ice. Rask!
Fire opal ring. And its helm. I don't know what that means when that happens. Its soul is released or something? Alright, there might be more stuff in there.
Sure.
Oh, stop making the spooky sounds.
Hey, how are things going?
Anything else in here? Oh! Another helmed horror. Other than that, yeah, stuff to loot. Look forward to it.
Hurry up!
You hurry
Good
up!
Good job!
You didn't see her?
Gotcha. Alright, alright!
I want to drag it out if I can.
You can count- Good job!
Here it comes. If not, I would have shot an arrow at it.
Good job!
Sure! Oh,
don't close the door. Wait. Okay. Attack, except for you.
Hey, how are things going?
What, you don't approve of us killing the helmed horrors? Too bad.
Why me?
Hey, how are things going?
They really don't stand a chance against Minsk and his flaming sword. +4 against undead. And then the other sword is +3 against undead. Damage and to hit. That's awesome. It's gotta be one of the best swords in the game. Anything else in here? Apparently not. That's trapped. Shall we all come in here?
Why me?
Nope, good job.
Alright, what about...
Alright.
Anything else in here? It's like a forge smithy of some kind.
You bunch of chumps! What the hell do you think you was doing?
Killing helmed horrors and getting loot? Really, where's your sense of adventure, Kagan? Okay, we got a magical warhammer. 43 gold. Warhammer +1. And that's too much for him. Let's see, this is weight 6. This is weight 6 as well. These are 3. Also, this is weight 9. Well, because one can spare weight but not slots, and the other one can spare slots but not weight. And then what else? This is gonna be 10 pounds. You know what? I'm gonna take. I don't know how much I can fit in here. So that just doesn't put all it can fit in the stack. So I'm going like that, okay. Four. Dino here can carry it. Then we got another slot for him. Save the. Well, I can't put it in the potion thing, so I'm gonna. Yeah, let him carry it. Compass Wardstone, I can put that in here and it won't take up any weight. There we go. Alright, so. In here.
Well, good job!
I already disarmed it. Okay. Three potions of healing, oil of speed, magical darts, arrows, bolts, another ward stone, and 10 bullets. Yeah, right? So these are bullets plus 2. One left, can you believe that? Yeah, you take these. Plus one. I just feel like using some of these up to make some room, so she'll use those. Bolts of biting, which we've dropped before. We'll drop them again. So let's see what they might be. Dart plus one. Arrow. No. She can't identify these. Emma when the arrows plus 2. Oh, thanks. Arrows plus 1. Arrow plus 2. Does someone else have arrow plus 2? No, not really. Alright. So I'm going to start using. Actually, yeah, you finish up these and I'll use the. I'll use these afterwards. There we go. They look almost the same, plus 1 and plus 2. Alright, and then a ward stone. Maybe this is the bone ward stone. It is! The glyph on this stone resembles a jumble of human bones. Awesome. Alright. I think we're almost done with this level. So let's go back.
All right.
To that room with the machine. And they go this way.
No less than done.
I deny you going that way.
As well as I can.
It wasn't as well as you could before, for sure. No sense in us all going. Oh. We've got this. Oil of speed. Yeah, there's no sense in us all going, so... I've minced to take this. Over to the machine. You know, just in case.
My temper shield! Vita mortis.
Excellent.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick.
He's using both swords. You can just barely see the other one. You can definitely see the flaming one. So, I guess I just click it. Does it go in automatically? A small inscription above a small key slot same thing as we read before. When you insert the bone ward stone into the machine's key slot, you feel the machine hum for a few moments and then quiet down. You are sure that something is turned off. Hopefully the glyphs have been turned off and not the machine. Same message, alright. He still has the bone ward stone. Hopefully we won't regret this. Kagan, you have the most hit points.
All right.
Seems fine.
I need an ale.
Okay. Huh. Seems like a marketplace or something. And just because we passed that trap...
Good job.
...doesn't mean there wouldn't be others. Huh. Very interesting. Trapped. Is this one trapped as well? I'm willing to bet it is. Yes. Alright. 201 gold. Some kind of magical leather armor and a magical mace, a Zios gem, and a Star Diopside gem. Cool. Cannot identify that. Okay. So this is, a mace? Croton's Skull Crusher plus 2. Even the Hordes have their heroes, and while they are vilified in civilized company, their deeds are sometimes impressive nonetheless. Croton was an exceptionally intelligent orc, as far as orcs go, who commanded an ever-shifting legion of ogres, orcs, hobgoblins, and other assorted beasties during the Year of the Lost Lady, 1241 DR. Dal Reckoning. It was in this year that a group of orc bandits allegedly kidnapped and killed a Tetherian noblewoman, and the response from authorities was a genocidal slaughter of orcs throughout the south in her memory. Croton mounted a defense that ensured his people were not entirely destroyed, though they were displaced. Croton himself fell near the end of the conflict, and his head was mounted outside the graveyard where the young lady was buried. As a point of interest, orcs called this time the Year of Pushing Too Far. Thaco plus 2, 1d6 plus 3 crushing, of course. Mace, one-handed strength. Not usable by... Druid Mage Monk. You know, instead of saying this, it should say who it is usable by. Because sometimes the list is very long. I think I've said that before. Alright, so a cleric or priest can use it. This we don't know. Does she want to use it, though? That's a good question. Does that go plus 2? 1d6 plus 3. That go plus 2. 1d4 plus 3 plus 1 electrical damage. This is really close. 1d6 plus 3 versus 1d... I mean, it's basically 1d5 plus 3 because it's plus 1. So... it has the potential to hit for one harder point, but... this can always hit for... at least... 5. If you hit 1, roll a 1 on a d4, plus 3, plus 1, 5. So, and this... you've got 4. So if you roll low on the damage, you get 4. You can get higher with a 9. So I'm sure you guys understand what I'm trying to say. This, if you roll 4, you get 8. So I'm going to keep her using the Bashrix hammer like she has been, and we'll sell this thing. Yeah. Alright, I want to identify this, but I only have one scroll left. How heavy is this? It's pretty heavy. 7. Actually carry it.
Yep. Right. Hey, how are things going?
All right, let's see what's in the other chest and then we'll figure this out. Oh wow. So a magical tower shield, 5,547 gold. Insane. Turquoise gem, 2 bloodstone gems, and the magical sling. Just barely fit everything. Ooh, look at... ooh! That's for Amethyst. Arla's Dragonbane plus 3. It's a plus 3 sling. None know better than halflings the value of a well-placed stone when confronting a larger foe. This particular weapon was the property of a young woman named Arla Surestep, one of the few small folk that left the hearth to seek adventure. Legend speaks of the diminutive Arla using this sling to place a well-sharpened pebble through the skull of a green dragon in mid-flight. Quite a feat. Though the same tale in another tavern places the stone squarely in the creature's hindquarters for more humorous than lethal effect. It would seem that halflings prefer entertainment over accuracy when it comes to their history. Makes sense. Echo plus 3, damage plus 3. Sweet. So we both have plus 2 slings. Now... oh, plus 1 actually. Wow. The changes look are damage 4 to 7, 7 to 10. Nice. Shield unidentified. I have to identify both of these. I wonder if it's safe to rest here. How do I use up my last scroll? And even if I do, I'll still be wondering what the other thing is.
All right.
Make sure we've determined things are not trapped over here.
Such menial tasks.
As well as I can.
Fine.
Hey,
what
are things
going?
Wills it.
Alright. Let's see if we can rest and then identify these things. Good. Very good. Okay. The shield is Pellin's shield plus 2. Look at the griffin on it. This shield was commissioned from the finest dwarven smiths by Pellin of Tyr, a renowned paladin who was known for his unquestioning courage and total lack of common sense. Upon hearing that a red dragon was ravaging the countryside, Pellin mounted his horse and rode off to do battle. Pellin and his armor digested readily, but the shield gave the dragon severe stomach cramps. He coughed it up, and it lay in his treasure pile for several years until it was removed by Pellin's son, a paladin who knew when to sneak. The superior craftsmanship is supplemented by a permanent lightness spell, which makes the shield very easy to wield. Cool. Armor class plus 3, an extra plus 1 versus missile attacks. Could help him. Armor class plus 2. Too bad it doesn't give as much... The other shield doesn't give as much against missile attacks as the other. Armor class plus 2. Plus 3. Versus plus 1 instead of missile attacks. Yeah. And then... This also helps against petrification and such. Plus 1 bonus. So I actually wonder if she can use this. She can. I mean, this thing is so cool looking though. Mirror shield. You know, it was saying that we have some... There's something around here that can turn people to stone? Or something? But we might not encounter that creature? But we might encounter that creature. Maybe I'll keep her using that for now until we're done here? And then this... Karaja's life and death plus 3. Karaja was Kalimshan's undisputed champion of pit fighting for a decade. Wearing only a thin leather armor and spiked gauntlets, he would pummel his foes to the ground, seemingly impervious to their blows. Eventually it was revealed that his armor was heavily enchanted, at which point angry spectators threw him into the pit with a club-wielding ogre. The beast managed to break all of Karaja's bones while the armor remained as good as new. Oh god, that's horrible. Armor class 5, 7 versus piercing and missile. Can't be as good as this. Armor class 4. Sadly, I don't... yeah. I don't see anyone who can wear it. Alright, well that's interesting though. Shall we change our spells back then? I think we've outlived sleep. Is there anything else that we should be using? Maybe blindness? Charm person, maybe? That's protection from evil, just one person. Protection from petrification. For one creature. But I think Diner here has that memorized. Yeah, she's got two. Alright. But blindness, I think I use that. Oh, we already have one. I never use charm person. I guess another magic missile. Wow. So much for level 1 spells. I mean, can use chromatic orb, but it's never been as effective. At least not that I've seen. So we'll try resting again. Let's get these spells back. Good. So the only place we haven't gone is here? Do we go back here? It says we have to go take three different paths and then come back or something? I must understand three of the paths that led to this place. After that, the way will become clear. The evil here, something not part of the tower. That's the demon knight or whatever showed up. The undead knight showed up at the top. Well, not the top, but the main floor. Alright, let's go.
Sure.
Hopefully this is still deactivated. Good. Oh, where do you think you're going?
As well as I can.
You are not allowed to leave the group like that.
No less than done.
You okay. So we can take this ward stone and put it back. Anything else coming on here?
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
Leaving is what I offer. Lexi might teleport us outside the place if we agreed to leave. So we return back to this and talk to the golem? I don't know what else to do.
Alright.
I do remember something about that. You're supposed to come back again and again. So, does the map of this place west, south, east? I don't even know. Those directions, I wonder if it corresponds to the map of this place here. Possible we missed, Oh, this is another one we couldn't get through. Maybe we have a stone. Didn't we get a ward stone after that? Hold up.
I don't want to talk.
We get through here, in an annoying way. We have to go through this. Can't see any of the way through. Let the fighters catch up. Some of these things might have come back. In fact, yes, they did. No one held yet, right? A pearl.
Tempest, give us victory!
No, he's held now, but it's okay. Silver necklace.
Hello?
She has more of these, though. I forget what they look like. Remove, yeah, we got three of them, might as well use it.
Manus, potentis, paro.
Remove for a whole bunch. He's still nauseated. Poor Minsk.
Go pester someone else. Why me?
Nothing waiting to come up on us here. Snort, snort. It was nothing. I don't even know what that's supposed to be. Wug. We got in. Nice.
Why me?
I forget what Wardstone had said we needed, but
what you want?
It was something.
Good job.
I'm just walking all over anyway. Throne. It looks like she can cast a spell on it.
Thy decency is refreshing. So many we
hey,
need are
how are things going?
Lacking.
Thank you for your kind words.
$72. Got a better look at this place. Bunch of weapons. Oh my god! 13,950 gold. That's insane. Oh my god. We have over 90,000 gold. I mean, what can we buy with all that? Just anything we want. Turquoise gem.
I like
Jasper
it here,
gem.
Where the gold grows.
Zircon gem. Moonstone gem. Zios gem. Gemorific, Star of the Upside, Aquamarine. Oh, she's full. Give me as many of this crap as you can. That's a lot of gems.
Hurry up!
Yes? A simple matter.
Just have her take them directly. Aquamarine. Horn coral. Sphene. Water opal. Yeah, we need to... It's got some room. This can't be heavy. Weight zero, here. I got three slots. Magic blocking. There you go.
A simple matter.
Ooh! It scares the hell out of me every time. Water opal. Moon bar gem. I remember that one. Moon bar is a pearly white opaque gemstone, usually pale blue with green and gold modeling. Related in type to fire and black opals, it is only slightly more common. Rare. Star Sapphire, Diamond, Emerald, and another one of those rogue stones. They're very expensive. available here.
Fine.
And then we got a magic short sword. Plus one. Useful. Alright, so what about this?
Alright.
Oh! That teleported us back. Okay. We can answer more questions?
A simple matter.
This is saying something different, I think. There was no warning, but it would not have helped. There was no need to prepare for hard times, because hard times would never come. So we were assured, and so we believed. The great troll killer was our provider, and he would protect us. We put down our swords to live the life he always wanted. We lived as family. Suspicions were for outsiders. Guards and weapons were for wartime. There was no warning, but it would not have helped. Huh. We came to kill, but not without reasons. Again, these are the doppelgangers. You were here before, as were the tentacles. Their underground was sneer, and the tower intruded on their expansions. As well, the bait was too great to pass. The dwarves did not hide their wealth. Now, everything else is S, and then we got H's repeating. Did not stop the rumors of waist-deep gold. The invaders came and still come, but not without invite. We came to kill, but not without reasons. The tower intruded on their expansions. Their underground was near. It was they. The bait was too great to pass. They were tempted by the gold, and the tower intruded on someone's expansions. Underground was near, maybe the Underdark. And this one we have to answer questions, I guess, again. We crafted as we were told. We built this place to prevent all from entering. We trapped every inch of every step and made sure that to enter meant death. We have killed many over time, though it is not our will. It is all to protect against the repeat of the past, though the challenges ensure it will repeat. A mountain to climb, a river to cross. Because it is there, they will come. We crafted as we were told. Okay, so here they built the place. This is again invading. But with reason, supposedly. To protect or against a repeat of the past. Because it is there, they will come. And then... there was no warning. Hmm.